Hi everybody, this is Nerdcore Unlimited and we're going to talk about La Mujer Murciélago, aka Batwoman. La Mujer Murciélago appeared back in 1960 in Mexico and was inspired by... That's right, Batman, 1960 TV series. Interesting fact, 30% of the population in Mexico only had TVs, but one producer actually saw the show and say, you know what, I can make this show, but instead of the man, a woman. But to show the woman is strong, she is a wrestler. That's when the Mexican exploitation began, from 1960 to all the way to 1978, and include two great characters ever. El Santo like Superman, Blue Demon like Batman, but we're gonna talk about them in another episode. But back to the Batwoman.
¿Qué tal, amigo Robles? ¿Me trae buenas noticias?
Sí, inspector. De acuerdo con lo que hablamos, me comuniqué con la persona que nos puede ayudar y con la cual he trabajado ya en la solución de varios casos.
La Mujer Murciélago.
Sí, señor. Le expliqué todo y está dispuesta a colaborar con nosotros.
¡Magnífico! ¿Quién es esa mujer? ¿No sabes quién es?
No. Es difícil describirla con palabras. Ella es una maravillosa mujer inmensamente rica que vive en la capital. Su fortuna la ha puesto al servicio de la justicia, luchando incansablemente en contra del mal. Dotada de unas cualidades poco comunes, en corto tiempo logró dominar todos los deportes.
Just like his friends say, they work together to solve mysteries. A woman with a lot of money, rich like Bruce Wayne, to use his money for justice and learn different abilities in every sport. Now, what is the reason the Batwoman decide to go to solve this mystery? It's because they keep finding dead bodies for wrestlers in Acapulco, but the funny part, interesting part, is the brain. Some parts of the brain is missing. But why is the reason? What is the purpose? The Batwoman decide to go undercover in the wrestlings to see who is the one choosing them or how they doing it. Now, something interesting. Batwoman don't have a Batcave. So, why? Because... remember, the locker room is a sacred area so the wrestlers can take the mask off. It's a sacred area, remember. Nobody is seeing it, keeping it secret. Also, Batwoman has a radio to communicate to friend to keep an eye who is the person trying to do that. What is the reason? What evil purpose whoever is doing it gonna create? Now, it's interesting. But watch it.
Perfecto. Perfecto. Prepárate, Igor. Prepárate. Vas a presenciar lo más grandioso del siglo. De las aguas del mar hace más de 400 millones de años emanó el principio de la raza humana. Al surgir a la vida, el primer vertebrado.
That's right. A man fish. Batwoman finds the secret location of which one is a ship, but she was captured before telling the authorities and take it to the leader, the doctor. Just like every campy movie, they get captured, guess what they do? Escape. She grabbed acid and tossed it in the face of the doctor and she escaped. Out there she showed her abilities of wrestler. Also, just like Batman, has small bumps. Also, that too, like every movie back in 1960. Only part, she's almost covered completely in the beach, but when she's Batwoman, she's in a bikini. Interesting. Also, they had a car chase. Wow, car chase. If you notice, she had her car looks kind of a little bit a Batmobile. Also, her makeup box become a gun.
¡Quietos! ¡Atrás!
The monster get bigger, from small to huge, and become aggressively and attack anybody. The doctor actually tried to tell the monster to seduce her anger and destruction he will give you a female. Also, if you notice, all the movies you see is either a man or woman wrestler, they has to have a match in the movie. It's mandatory, no questions asked. The monster tried to kidnap her, her friend tried to help, but since the monster is too powerful, the friend can do nothing about it. But they, before that, they find out they can create some type of device to seduce or attract the monster. His friend is completely out, but in the end he helped her and find out their device. Later on, the doctor kidnapped their friends, bring her to the secret base, well, the jet, boat, and try to transform her to the monster. But as you notice, they implant the device, which one make the monster go against his creator.
Quítale la máscara.
And escape, like every movie, before the destruction. Now, if I gonna grade the movie, I will not doing it because everybody's doing it. What I gonna do is to show the perspective of the cinematography. It's actually interested, it's made in Mexico. It is not bad. They show different things. Guns, wrestling, wrestling match, car chase, different things. Try to keep the audience entertained with different attractions. Even try to show gadgets. On which one today, they don't do it. I know it's campy, you see their bad acting, but it's entertaining. It's like, well, it's interesting. It's actually a pop art. Interesting fact, DC actually tried to create a comic book based on her, but since it's a knockoff from their own original, they can do it. that's impressive. Even they tried to make toys, even they tried to introduce her to a multiverse. That good it is. That's the reason even DC don't even try to sue them. But once again, this is Nerdcore Unlimited, and see you soon.